Out Stormview Doppler radar. A couple of showers and thunderstorms are popping up, all below severe criteria, but some heavier downpours lurking very close to St. Joseph, finally moving off to the east and northeast. Immediate metro, dry for the time being, but we're going to focus our attention farther to the southwest, where we could see some more showers and thunderstorms popping up. Right now, though, they're not really that large, they're not lasting that long, and probably after sundown, we'll probably see mostly clear skies across the area. Here is our next graphic as we look at storm reports from last night. It was mostly wind damage that we had to worry about, close to Tonganoxie, then again toward Oak Grove, and eventually heading farther to the east, Lone Jack, and then right on 50 Highway, down toward Knobnoster, Sedalia, eventually heading toward the Lake of the Ozarks. A couple of hail reports earlier as well out over Kansas. So we're going to see some scattered downpours. Not everybody's going to see it. I think it'll be less than 20% coverage for the entire viewing area. More humid than it was this morning. If you stepped outside this morning, you thought, hey, not too bad. You step outside this evening, still, it's going to be rather uncomfortable. And very little cooling is expected overnight. Chief Meteorologist Bryan Busby here in the First Alert Weather Center. 87 degrees, although we were peaking out close to 90. 96 is what it felt like. And as we do our rain check, the month of July normally is a dry month, but this year anything but. 6.7 inches for just the month, and that's at Kansas City International Airport. Normally 3.1, and last year 3.6, so way ahead. And this is part of the reason, just looking at some of my weather watchers from last night, 2.5 inches in Gladstone, about 1.5 inches for Ottawa, as well as Grandview. And on the Kansas side, still at least 1 inch, 1.3 for KCK, 1.6 in Green Valley, and 1.1 in Lee's Summit. Heat index readings still close to 100 degrees, especially farther to the south. A brief respite for the time being, but the heat advisory has already been posted from tomorrow morning through Friday night. And I put the exclamation point there because usually they'll let it stop at 8 o'clock at night because it should cool down after the sun goes down. But it looks like we're going to stay very warm even Thursday night into Friday, as temperatures are not going to budge much at all. And as you see here, the excessive heat warning does include even some more folks north of the river, then farther to the south toward Butler, Ottawa, Paola, and Emporia. So here's the situation as far as the rain is concerned. Some showers and thundershowers moving across the northern portion of the region. But overnight tonight, with the exception of those spotty rumbles and rain, it will be a bit breezy, south at around 5 to 10 miles per hour. So the low-lying areas that don't get as much wind, you're going to see some fog. 78 degrees for the morning. And according to FutureScan, we still see a good deal of sunshine out there, so it will be clearer. But with the winds coming in fairly strong out of the south and southwest, probably not as much fog even during the daytime hours on your Thursday. But hot stuff coming through. 98 are high with south breezes at 10 to 20 miles per hour. 95 on Friday with a chance of thunderstorms returning into the first portion of Saturday. Otherwise, the heat is on.